You're watching Unrelent Gaming. This is Beerus, the God of Destruction. Make sure you subscribe to Unrelent Gaming and push the like button for me, or else I'll hakai you from existence.
Oh, and do make sure to watch the entire video all the way through. And follow Unrelent Gaming on both Instagram and Twitter.
Whis, enough. On to the video.
With Dragon Ball Super manga chapter number 76 looming over the horizon, scheduled to be released in just about a few days, here today we have additional news information, spoilers, leaks, and images in regards to the upcoming battle involving both Granola and the Saiyans following the previous encounter featuring Ultra Ego Vegeta versus Granola, which had now gone on to establish Granola as being a much bigger threat than how he was before, which ultimately now begs the question as to whether or not Goku or Vegeta could get the job done by themselves in taking down Granola or not. Or if simply put, Granola is simply going to battle either one of them, if not both at the same time, in having to bulldoze over the two and smashing them both completely. But before we dive any further into the spoilers, if of course you guys are new to the channel and just so happen to love Dragon Ball and anime, then I do encourage you guys to go on ahead and smash that subscribe button and turn on all notifications by clicking on the bell icon to never miss a single video posted onto the channel, as well as also giving this video a big fat thumbs up by slapping that like button down below if you guys are simply excited to see Vegeta versus Granola go down, as of course courtesy of the Dragon Ball News website and DBS Hype over on Twitter, the following Dragon Ball Super manga chapter number 76 leaks and spoilers goes as follows. Now, as of course you guys can see here on your screen, we do in fact actually have a summary courtesy of DBS Chronicles, and the following summary spoilers goes as follows. Now, it goes on to read, the first pages are those that have been seen in the preview. Granola continuously attacks Vegeta until he loses his Ultra Ego form. When Granola is about to finish him off, Goku appears by using Super Saiyan Blue and hits Granola in the face, sending him away from Vegeta. Goku tells Vegeta that he will now take care of Granola, but Vegeta doesn't accept it and kicks Goku on his side, sending him flying against a drum of water. Vegeta approaches Goku and tells him don't interfere, then punches Goku in the face. While they argue, Granola approaches Vegeta and tries to pierce his abdomen with the palm of his hand. Goku reacts on time and pushes Vegeta with a shockwave. Granola only manages to scratch Vegeta a bit. Vegeta crashes into a house and seemingly is unconscious. Goku and Vegeta keep fighting. Granola moves quickly to block Goku's attack. Goku notices it and strengthens his neck, which again, Granola is trying to target his vital points. Now, it then goes on to continue. Granola hits Goku on the neck. Goku returns to his normal form and falls unconscious to the ground, which is full of water. Granola leaves thinking that he had defeated Goku, but Goku was pretending and throws a ki ball at Granola's back. Granola is angry, so he tries to pierce Goku's abdomen with his hand. However, Goku uses the same trick as before, strengthens his abdomen, and stops Granola's attack. Then he punches Granola in the stomach. Vegeta wakes up and sees that Goku and Granola are still fighting. Despite Goku facing up to Granola, he kicks Goku against the ground. Goku returns once again back down to his normal form. Vegeta tells Goku to let him fight his way. Goku accepts and asks him not to die. Vegeta transforms back into his Ultra Ego form. Granola is surprised. The battle moves from the Shigerian City, and Granola tells Vegeta to go elsewhere, but Vegeta ignores him. So once again, Vegeta is back in this fight. We do get to see somewhat of a brief interaction between Granola and Goku, but Vegeta wants in, and the way he does this is by telling Goku, don't get in my way, right? So, for part 2, the summary then continues. The fight continues fiercely. Granola punches Vegeta, and Vegeta bites his arm. Granola slams Vegeta to the ground, then he steps on his arms. This way, Vegeta can't move and shoots several ki blast attacks point blank at Vegeta's face. Granola sits on the ground because he is exhausted. Suddenly, a wall of a house collapses, and Granola sees inside a Shigerian, a mother with a child. She looks at Granola terrified. A little flashback of Granola begins, and we see him as a child running away from the city that the Saiyans have attacked. Granola enters into a church and meets his mother. They both hug, but a noise interrupts them, and they look at something terrified. Back to the present, Vegeta gets up, and enraged Granola punches him, sending Vegeta out of the city. Granola is about to finish him off. He begins to focus his energy energy into a giant ki ball. Vegeta is exhausted but is willing to try to resist the attack anyway. Goku runs up to them but also is exhausted. Suddenly, a spaceship appears full of speed next to Goku. Inside of it is the Namekian Monaito, and the ship is piloted by Granola's robot Oatmeal. Goku tries to stop Granola but he can't. Monaito opens the spaceship and calls Granola. He is surprised to even see Monaito. Goku attacks Granola and stops his attack. The ship lands and Monaito gets out of it. Monaito then goes on to say, 40 years ago, the one who saved us was a Saiyan named Bardock. Now, we've already known from the beginning of this entire story that it was Bardock who went on to save Granola, and it's interesting that Monaito went on to bring this up, and no, the fight between our said characters was indeed not over because Vegeta tried to use his Ultra Ego form to the best of his ability. He's exhausted, Granola's exhausted, Goku's exhausted, which by the end of it isn't really a good sign because this only just means that whenever the heaters are about to make their move, they're going to capitalize on an exhausted team. But either way, with Bardock now being mentioned and with Bardock being kind of displayed as being the hero of said characters that went on to save Granola and possibly even Monaito himself, I think is a very cool thing because perhaps maybe this is going to be somewhat of a callback to Granola in telling him, hey, the Saiyans aren't that bad because by the end of it, you were in fact saved by one. So the spoilers do go on to shed more light that Vegeta wants this fight with Granola, and by the end, it looks as though neither one of them really lost because with Vegeta going back into his Ultra Ego form, which we don't even know as of right now if he went on to use his Senzu Bean or not, perhaps maybe he's acting on instinct, but even then, Goku's playing the role of simply helping Vegeta get out of the way right before Granola actually went on to target said vital points, which goes on to shed even more light on the teamwork that the two have gone on to establish. But even then, it really goes on to kind of ask many questions, especially towards the end, to suggest, is this the end of the chapter? Is the chapter going to end off with Monaito revealing that Granola was in fact saved by Bardock, or will there be more, right? But in the end, I want to go on ahead and get your thoughts in the comment section below, not only about the spoilers, but about the overall narrative written in the fact that Granola now seems to be placed in such a position where he is dominant, and it doesn't look as though taking this guy down by any means is going to be easy. So do you guys think that perhaps maybe this is BS in a sense where Toriyama and Toyotaro had wrote this narrative into where Granola seems to be indestructible even when confronting the strongest variations of both Goku and Vegeta? And more specifically, what are your thoughts on Vegeta having to go back into this fight in going as far as to ask and tell Goku that he wants to do this on his own, with Goku having to agree? So essentially, is this some kind of a sign for Vegeta and Granola in this arc and having them be the ones to finish this entire fight? Or do you guys genuinely believe that something else is going to happen? As again, we are going to be covering the entirety of this manga chapter when it drops in English on September 20th. So make sure that you guys mark the date down because we're going to be covering everything from start to finish. So that way you guys have a better understanding as to what the heck is going on involving Goku, Vegeta, the heaters, and Granola. So again, thank you all so much for watching. Thank you all so much for your time. I just really hope that as we continue to go forward, the story narrative remains consistent and they don't end up including somewhat of a caveat to where it throws everything off balance again, because we've seen that be done before and I'm really hoping that it doesn't happen again. So if you guys are new to the channel, then be sure to go on ahead and smash that subscribe button, as well as also turning on all notifications by clicking on the bell icon to never miss a single video posted onto the channel, as well as also giving this video a big fat thumbs up by slapping that like button down below if you guys are excited and if you guys enjoyed. And I'll be seeing each and every single one of you down the comment section below and in the next video. I hope you guys have a great day and take care. Peace. And a quick little reminder before you exit the video, if you guys are unaware, follow me on my secondary channels, which are also used to discuss and talk about all kinds of different subjects and topics, including gaming and live streams, beginning with Unreal Network, which is a channel dedicated in discussing all kinds of movies, breakdowns, current events, scary stories, theories, and more. So if you are someone who is into the entertainment world, then that's the channel for you. So head on over and subscribe over on Unreal Network, which up next is Unreal Vlogs, where I bring you guys a little closer into my life in taking you behind the scenes with vlogging content, parody videos, reactions, motivational videos, uplifting videos, and more. So if you want to get to know me on more of a personal level, then that's the channel for you. Hit that subscribe button to always be in the loop with Unreal Vlogs. And lastly, my gaming channel, Unreal Royale, where on that channel we dive more into the world of gaming, ranging from all different kinds of video games, from Dragon Ball to Resident Evil to Grand Theft Auto, Halo, Gears of War, Minecraft, all kinds of horror games, shooters, RPGs, and more. more, including live streams. So if you're a gamer and are into the gaming world, then smash that subscribe button over at Unreal Royale and experience the ride with me. I want to thank you all so much for your time. Thank you all so very much for your support. And I'll be seeing each and every single one of you in the next video.
This is the Galactic Emperor of the Universe. And of course, I'm here to tell you to subscribe to Unrelent Gaming.
Also follow Unrelent Gaming on these social media platforms to stay connected at all times. And if you don't, then very soon you will all be dead. Oh, did someone say Unrelent Gaming? Oh my god.
The fuck, Zarbon? Put on some clothes!
Well, why don't you put on any clothes?
What? I don't need clothes. Jesus Christ, that's huge! What, Broly?
Freezer.
Uh-oh.
Prepare to die!
Boo, I'm a real gaming! But once you get video, I'll lots of likes! Or Boo will turn you into chocolate!
Vados, get over here! Tell these mortals that I'm the biggest Unreal Engine gaming fan! This is my moment! I'm a part of his notification squad! Universe 7 can have all the fun! I just want the food!
And don't forget to leave a comment on this video! Show some love for the best community on YouTube!
Kakarot!